I wanted to find out if GPT-4 Turbo could help me create a video game, even though I've never worked on one in a professional environment like Unity. The twist? I won't write any code myself. All the code we'll use will be crafted by ChatGPT. And I'm sticking to a rule, I can't tweak anything ChatGPT churns out. I'll just copy and paste the code, no adjustments allowed.
This is a terrible idea.
Why Flappy Bird? Because Flappy Bird is simple enough to fit into one video, yet it involves the same process as more complex games. I started with a brief description of all the components that go into Flappy Bird. GPT snapped back with a 6-step plan pronto. Let's follow the plan together and see if we can create a Flappy Bird prototype in the next 10 minutes, without any prior game development knowledge, completely from scratch. We'll create a beautiful bird by just piecing together whatever we find first on the internet. Moving on, we'll breathe life into our bird so it flaps its wings, obeys gravity, and reacts to the space bar. Our next step is to construct pipes and nail down the bird's movements. Remember, all this happens without modifying a single line of code. It's all about blind faith in copy-paste. Too fast for you? Let's do everything together step by step. Let's start with a brief description of all the components that go into Flappy Bird. We want a controllable bird character that can flap. This bird should move towards the right side. It should experience gravity, and the player should be able to flap with the mouse or spacebar, and we need the regular appearance of pipes. And ChatGPT starts with creating a plan involving setting up the Unity project, setting up the game scene, scripting the player movements, generating obstacles, adding game mechanics, and of course polishing and testing. Let's start with step one, setting up the Unity project. For this, we first have to install Unity, therefore let's download it, in my case, the version for Macs. Then we start the installation by agreeing to everything that is presented to us. Before we can create a new Unity project with the Unity Hub, we have to create a Unity account. We enter our data and hit the green button. Oh no, we forgot the captcha. This is probably the hardest part of this tutorial. We confirm the email and we are good to go. Unity Hub asked us to install the Unity editor in the latest version. Sounds like a plan. When everything is installed, we can click on New Project. We choose a 2D project and change the name to Flappy Clone. It seems that the Unity editor is starting. Okay, great, we have a clean canvas in front of us. Let's ask our best coding buddy, GPT, how to proceed. We have to import assets. That means we need sprites for our bird. That means an upflap and a downflap image and some green pipes. Let's check what the internet offers. The first link looks promising. There is a folder for sprites. Wow, we found the Flappy Bird developer heaven. Let's first download the downflap PNG. Okay. And now we need the upflap image. Together they simulate the flapping. And a beautiful green pipe. Let's move these new images into our project. What next? Let's move over to GPT to see what step 2 includes. We have to create the player. For this, we have to drag the bird sprites into the scene. Let's do this. I select the bird image and drag it in the middle of the scene. Let's click the play button to see our new game in action. Looks good. Blue Flappy on a blue background. Every UX designer would scream in agony. What next? GPT suggests adding gravitation. But where is the part with the animation? Currently, the bird is not flapping. Let's ask GPT how we can make the bird flap. Okay. In step 3, GPT mentions that we can use the window animation menu to create a new clip. Let's give it the name Bird Flap. We try to drag the images into the animation timeline, and I hope that's all we have to do. Okay, the moment of truth, we click the play button. It's probably the most beautiful bird I have ever created. Okay, we have to apply physics to the bird. For this, we have to add something called rigid body 2D. But there is no explanation of how to do this. Let's dive deeper and ask GPT. All right, with the object selected, we can click the Add Component button in the inspector on the right side. Okay, there it is. We select rigid body 2D. Let's try it out. And yes, the bird is now experiencing gravity. What's next? We also need a box collider 2D. Let's continue with the obstacles. We have to drag our pipe image into the scene and adjust it as needed. Then we have to add box collider 2D. And at the end, we have to drag the game object into our assets folder to create a so-called prefab. Let's create a new game object and move our green pipe into it. Then we do the same again for our bottom pipe. We only need to rotate it by 180 degrees. I'm curious how this looks. Very cool, falling Flappy in front of pipes. We add the box collider 2D as we have learned with Flappy earlier, but I see that the collider boxes are really off. Let's adjust the tiny rectangles so that they match the actual pipes. In the preparation for this video, when I worked the first time ever with Unity, I forgot this step and the bird flew through the pipes. Okay, the last step is to move the game object down into our assets area. What's next? We have to script the player movement. For this, we need a new C# script and attach it to the bird. This should allow us to manage the bird's flapping. Do you remember rule number one? We don't write code, therefore we have to ask GPT to write it for us. Let's wait until GPT has finished all the necessary code. We just click on copy. Next, we create an empty script in our assets area. When we click on Open, it automatically opens the default editor. In my case, it's Visual Studio Code. We overwrite the default code by pasting in the script created by GPT. Let's see if we can attach the script by dragging it on the bird flap game object. Nope. All right, but we have learned that we can add stuff by clicking on the Add Component button. Drumroll. When everything works, we can now control our Flappy Bird with the spacebar. Yes, it works. Two pipes are not enough. We need another script that is able to spawn pipes. So let's ask GPT. Let's wait until GPT has finished all the necessary code. Again, we copy the script. We create a new script in the assets area. And we open it. We paste it and don't change anything. GPT also produced a second script for the movement. Let's copy it too. Again, we create a script, rename it, and open it in our editor. We paste everything, and I think we have all scripts together. Let's assign our movement scripts to the pipes, because the pipes should move from right to left while the bird stays in the center. Okay, that kind of works. Now we want to spawn more pipes. GPT mentioned that we need an empty game object for this and attach the spawner script to it. Let's do this. It appears we need to configure the spawner script to identify which assets it should spawn. Let's proceed by dragging the pipe assets into it. Now we have everything for a working proof of concept. that looks already like a very simple version of the origin game. Let's see if I can make it through the pipes. I don't recall the bird rotating in the original game, and some of the pipes are too low. We probably have to adjust the min height settings. But most important things first. Let's add a new background so that I can tell you to visit AIfordevs.com for more tutorials about AI topics. Perhaps it's a good business idea to offer branded Flappy Bird games. Let's adjust the min height. Okay, now the pipes are a little bit higher. Great, I'll stop here. If you're interested in adding scoring and other elements, just follow the steps GPT outlines and adjust the instructions as necessary. I hope you'll enjoy the process as much as I did. Also, be sure to check out our latest video on how to build a Jarvis assistant.